Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the Blazor Toggle Switch Button component from Syncfusion. With the Toggle Switch Button, you can perform a toggling action to switch between checked and unchecked states. In this video, I'll explain how easy it is to add a Blazor Toggle Switch Button to a server-side Blazor application. I will also show you how to configure a few of the control's basic properties like setting up a checked state, CssClass, toggle method, and other customizations. To explore more details about the Syncfusion Blazor Toggle Switch Button, refer to the website link in the card above. Let me start with the application creation process. I can create a Blazor application using either Visual Studio 2019 or Visual Studio Code. In this video, I'll show you how to create a server-side Blazor application using Visual Studio 2019. Make sure that you have installed it along with .NET Core SDK 3.1.2 or later. If you want to know more about the Blazor server app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, you can watch the video linked in the card above. Now, open Visual Studio 2019 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. Select Blazor app from the templates and click the Next button. Here, I'll name my project and click the Create button. Here, I will choose the Blazor server app and click the Create button. The project has been created and is ready for use. Now, I will show you the step-by-step process for adding a toggle switch button to it. To add and start using a toggle switch button, first I need to install the necessary Syncfusion Blazor packages. For that, I'll open the NuGet package manager, search for Syncfusion Blazor and install it in my application. Once it is installed, you can see that the Blazor packages are added to this application's packages folder. Now, to render a toggle switch button, first I'll navigate to the imports.razor page and import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor buttons. Then I need to register the Syncfusion Blazor service. To do that, I'll navigate to the startup.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then I'll make a call to the Syncfusion Blazor service method inside the configure services method. Within the configure method, I will register the Syncfusion license by passing the trial license key in the register license method. Next, I will navigate to the host.cshtml page to add a CSS reference from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. The configuration is done. Let's move on to adding the Blazor toggle switch button. For this, I will open the index component. Here, I will add a div tag with a few CSS styles to align my toggle switch button to the center of the index page. I will include the label. Then I will add the SF switch tag. By default, the toggle switch button is displayed in an unchecked state. To display it in a checked state, I will include the checker property and set its value to true. See the output, the switch button is rendered in a checked state. I can also uncheck it simply by clicking it. Next, I will show you how to set text over the toggle switch button to indicate the button states. Here, I will include the OnLabel property and set its value to on. Next, I will include the OffLabel property and set its value to off. See in the output, the label has been added for both the checked and unchecked states. Next, let me show you how to change the size of the toggle switch button. Our two options are default and small. So far, we have seen the default size of the toggle switch button. I can change it to a relatively small size by simply adding the CssClass property and setting its value to e-small. See the output. The toggle switch button has been rendered in a smaller size compared to its default size. Next, I will show you how to dynamically toggle between the states of the toggle switch button using the toggle method. First, I will add the SF button tag. Then I add the onClick event and assign the callback method changeState. Inside the @code directive, I'm going to define the changeState method and then I will include the @ref property in the toggle switch button to access its reference. After that, I'll access the toggle method using the ref property inside the changeState method. See the output. When I click the button, its state is changed through the toggle method. Finally, I will show you how to disable the toggle switch button. I add the disabled property and set its value to true. See in the output, the toggle switch button is now disabled. Now, let me provide a quick summary of what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to create a Blazor server app and add a toggle switch button component to it. And then I demonstrated a few of its basic properties like how to set the checked state, use CssClass, change its state using the toggle method, and other customizations. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see about getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for our community license from the link below. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.